Why you shouldn't copy your competitors' websites. That's today's topic on my e-commerce growth minutes. I'm Raphael and I'm the founder of Splitbase. So when we're looking for inspiration and we're trying to improve our websites, developing a new feature or launching a new product, one of our main reflexes is often to, you know, look at what our competitors are doing. It's pretty natural, right? Because they have that starting point and we don't necessarily want to start from scratch all over again. We kind of want to get some cue points from what they're doing. So why shouldn't you do that? Well, here's the deal. There's a difference between being inspired and copying a feature that they're doing or copying the text or the layout of things they're doing. In my experience working with, probably hundreds of e-commerce companies at this point, one thing that I've noticed is that yes, by default, a lot of companies are just going to want to copy new features, marketing tactics that other people are doing. The thing that people tend to forget is that you may want to copy your competitors, but you don't know what you're actually copying. For example, if you want to copy a certain feature or the look of a product page, what you don't know is if that product page layout, for example, is actually working for your competitors. What if what you're seeing on your competitor's website is something that you think is genius, but in reality, that's an A/B test that they're running, and what you're seeing is a losing variant? What if you're copying something that will not actually stick with the competitor for a long time? What if that competitor is testing dozens of variants for that one page and you're just seeing one side of it and it's probably the one that may not actually win? That's the risk of copying our competitors' websites. We tend to forget that they can also run A/B tests, that what you're seeing may not be actually work well for them. And sometimes we think our competitors are more advanced than we are. But I've been on the side of working with brands that before working with them, I thought they were way more advanced than they actually were. And then when you start looking inside the company and how they do things, turns out, well, there's stuff that's not being tracked, and what you're seeing, there's no particular reason why they did things in a certain way. It's just because it was someone's opinion, or they also copied from competitors. So that's, why you shouldn't copy from your competitors. What you should do instead is get inspired. Try to get as many different ideas from as many brands as possible if you really needed a starting point or some inspiration. And then go from there. But never forget that what your competitors are doing may not actually be better than what you may want to do from scratch. So that's it for today's minutes. If you like what you've heard, please take a moment to like or share this video or tag anyone that may find this interesting. And if you want more in-depth content like this, just make sure to listen to my podcast called Minds of E-commerce that you can find on iTunes, Stitcher, and all your platforms. Thank you so much for tuning in and see you next time.